Welcome to our channel. My name is Dennis Kaberia. Today we are going to learn about physics. Physics is the study of matter with its relation to energy. Okay, let's look at energy forms. We have various forms of energy forms, that is the chemical energy, that is the energy found in the atoms and the molecules. We have the nuclear energy, the energy in the nucleus of an atom. Then we have the electrical energy, the energy due to the movement of electrons. Then we have the light or radiant energy, the energy in X-rays, radio, those high-frequency waves. Then there is gravity. Gravity is also a form of an energy, but in a form of potential energy. Okay. When you hear about energy, there is one thing you should know, one law, the law of conservation of energy. This law is mandatory. This law is mandatory in every physics student. Law of conservation of energy. Energy is neither created nor destroyed, but transformed from one form to another. I will repeat it again. Energy is neither created nor destroyed, but transformed from one form to another. We shall continue on gravity. Gravity, as defined here, it is the force of attraction between two objects or a body or a mass, but of different masses. That is, two objects, but of different masses, is the force of attraction. That is what we call gravity. Then, let me take you back a little, back to the year 1665, during the times of Isaac Newton. It was a time in which London, there was a plague in London. It was a bubonic plague. It was called a bubonic plague. And Isaac had to isolate himself from London to Cambridge. That is 55 miles away from London to go to isolate himself to Cambridge. So it was during that time when Isaac came to discover about gravity. Then, remember, it was a quarantine moment. They were quarantined that time. So then later came another year, 1915, during the time of Albert Einstein. He came up with the theory of relativity, going against the gravity, but in somehow they came to conquer somewhere. So, in the theory of relativity, whereby gravity is the consequence of curvature in space-time, it is the consequence of curvature in space-time. That is the theory of relativity. That's how Albert Einstein defined gravity. He gave us two absolute values, that is the space and time. That is a single for this structure. He called it a single for this structure, space and time. Okay. Imagine of Earth orbiting in a circular elliptical path. But in reality, the Earth moves in a straight line through a space-time curved by the mass of the sun. Gravity is due to this curvature. That is, the Earth moving in an elliptical path is just some fantasy, because in reality, the Earth moves in a straight line through a space-time curved due to the mass of the sun. Now that force is the gravity, because the gravity is due to that curvature. Okay. It was later noted that with the time, the two theories, that is the two definitions of gravity according to Newton and according to Einstein, came to be accepted by physicists, because Newton dealt with classical physics, that is the large particles. He dealt with large particles or large bodies or large structures. But Einstein dealt with the quantum mechanics, that is, he dealt with the smallest particles of an element, that is the atom, the molecules, the electrons, or you can say even the infinitely small matter of an element.